Good evening, my name is Swapnali. Welcome to today's highlights of Speed News Live 24. Let's have a quick look on worldwide highlights. Prime Minister Narendra Modi Monday received his first dose of coronavirus vaccine at Delhi's premier All India Institutes of Medical Sciences. Sister P. Niveda from Puducherry administered Bharat Biotech's Covaxin to the Prime Minister. The Supreme Court on Monday asked the government employee who is accused of raping a girl if he would marry her, stroking a straw on a social media. A major blow, LPG cylinder prices were hiked by Rs 25 on Monday. Just 3 days ago, the prices were hiked by Rs 25. Twitter recently had something very similar to show, surreal and animated images of freedom fighters Bhagat Singh, Lokmanya Tilak, Kasturba Gandhi and spiritual leader Swami Vivekanand and the great master and teacher Aurobindo. Congress MP from Thiruvananthapuram, Shashi Tharoor, is known for his eloquent use of English languages, using words such as sesquicapitiline, Prespecity, Gonzo, etc. could form its own treasurers which people can't refer to. US President Donald Trump has raised the climate issues while criticizing his successor Joe Biden for rejoining the very unfair Paris Agreement, saying what good does it do when America is clean but China, Russia and India are not. In a tragic incident, a 20-year-old woman allegedly ended her life by setting herself on fire at a house of a relative in Tamil Nadu's Chennai, a week after her 24-year-old boyfriend killed himself. Pet ring auction in India began on Monday with 2,251.25 megahertz radio waves valued at Rs. 3.92 lakh crore up for bidding. BKU leader Rakesh Taiket has claimed that the center's silence for the past few days indicates that it is planning some steps against the farmers' agitation over newly enacted agricultural laws. The rupee ended 8 paise lower at 73.55 against the US dollar on Monday, weighed down by a spike in global crude oil prices and strengthening American currency. The Reserve Bank of India in its monthly bulletin for February 2021 said that the India's economic activity is gaining momentum as COVID-19 incidents receded, but private investment still remains concerned. Yami Gautam recently took to Instagram to share a throwback picture from her childhood. In the picture, she can be seen with her younger sister Sarli Gautam. Unified Payment Interference is a digital payment system developed by the NPCI that helps to intensely transfer funds between two banks through a mobile platform. The Union Health Minister on Monday issued a clarification regarding registration for coronavirus vaccine, saying that it can be done through a Cowin web portal and not the mobile application. Modi received the indigenously developed Covaxin jab by Bharat Biotech on Monday morning. Ames was intimated about the Prime Minister's visit to hospital to take the vaccine. The Government of India on Monday said that the total number of domestic passengers that travelled on February 28 rose to over 3.13 lakh with a total of 2,353 flights in the air. The biggest challenge in a seat distribution pertaining to Kerala Congress, the regional party headed by Jose K. Mani, which wields influence primarily among a Catholic Christian voters in the central Kerala. The PLA challenging the Election Commission decision to conduct assembly election over the 8 phases in West Bengal was filed in the Supreme Court. Amitabh Bachchan had his legion of fans worried as he revealed on Saturday night that he has undergone a surgery. The actor didn't reveal many details in his blog. Sharing a personal account while shooting Dil Dhadakne Do, Bollywood actor Anil Kapoor recently opened up about his favorite scene from the film which he was looking forward to shooting the most. With this, we end up with the today's highlights. Thank you.
For more videos and information, download Speed News Live 24 app and subscribe our YouTube channel.